Hello and welcome to Big Orbit's unboxing review of Magic Origins. So today I'm going to be opening up the booster box for Magic Origins. I'll go through the boosters. I'll mostly try and skip a lot of the commons as we've already seen through those. We just want to dig through into the rares really, don't we? Rares and mythics. So, set's just come out. Magic Origins is a story about the origins of lots of different planeswalkers. So the story of five of the iconic planeswalkers that we know. It originally was a core set, but they've switched their new two-block paradigm, so this has now been changed, and this has replaced a core set, so this is a very strong set, if you consider it in the eyes of being a core set, but it is more like an expert expansion. So, first pack. So, we'll jump through some of these. Fire Impulse, very nice limited card there. Evolving Worlds, classic. So, uncommons, we have Eye Blight Massacre, none else get -2/-2, and not as good as a certain other minus in card. Angel's Tomb, Gold Forge Sentinel, and Exquisite Firecraft, rare. One red red. Deals 4 damage to target creature player, and then the new spell mastery mechanic, which is new to this set. If you have 2 or more instants or sorceries in the graveyard, it can't be countered by spells or ability, so it becomes a 3 mana uncounterable 4 damage with sorcery speed. Not brilliant, not bad either. And then we have a land and some Gumph. So let's just split these up. Yeah, each of these 5 planeswalkers. So we have Gideon, Jace, Chandra, Liliana, and Nyssa. And we'll see, hopefully, see some of them through the pack. Costrobia, nice reprint. So we have Goblin Glory Chaser here. It's our first uncommon. Swift Reckoning. Magmatic Insight. And the Land of War Waste. So they've reprinted the Pain Lands for this set. So this is on multicolored card, multicolored lands. Of course, everyone's hoping in the next set, Battle for Zendikar, we'll see the fetches, but who knows? And then Forest, Scout Goliath, Foil, Shiny, and a Zombie Token. Because you always need more zombies. Again, jump through the commons. Yoked Arcs and the Gate, fantastic. So you have here Blessed Spirits, Mage Ring Network. There's a bit of a Mage Ring vertical cycle, I believe, going through the set. Shaman of the Pack, Kithian's Irregulars. So it's Human Soldier with Renown 1. Again, another new mechanic for the set. When the creature deals damage to combat damage to a player, if it's not renowned, put a 1/1 counter on it and it becomes renowned. Some of the cards have other abilities when they become renowned. Not me, sorry. This is very reminiscent of the recent mechanic with the Monstrosity. And then a Thopter token. So, the set's got quite a tribal theme to it. Octopus being one of them, if you want to believe it such. So, Touch Moonglove, Guardians of Melitus, Knight of Pilgrim's Road. So, first uncommon, Scout Goliath, Hydra Lash, Blightcaster, and then our rare, Dark Petition. So a lot of these cards are also showing the story of these planeswalkers and different parts of their life. So this one is dealing with Liliana and Grizzlebrand by the looks of it. So for 5 mana, you can search your library for a card, put it to hand, shuffle. So you can tutor a card And then if you also have Spell Mastery, you also get Dark Ritual effect added on top. So Tutor plus Dark Ritual for 5 mana. You can't complain at that. Again, this is showing this part of the story for Liliana. So, ooh, beautiful. We have a foil. Managorgia Hydra. So this is a rare from the set. It's a Trample Hydra for 3 mana, not X mana. But whenever a player casts a spell, it gets a 1-1 counter. So it's going to grow bigger as you play a card rather than in the initial drop. So again, jump through those. Bring Warden Owl, nice card for limited. Eros's Champion. Angel's Tomb. Draugr Invocation, and we've got an Evolutionary Leap. So 2 mana, green enchantment, pay a green, sack a creature, reveal cards from top of the library until you reveal a creature, put that card into your hand and the rest on the bottom of your library in a random order. So yeah, it's not a terrible enchantment. It'll have its place in a nice sort of Johnny deck, I believe, but there we go, just advertisement and another land. This is Pilgrimage, Natuko. Natuko Husk, very nice card for limited play. So, and Suppression Bonds. So we have Knightly Valor, Valor in Akros, Whirl a Rogue, and that is a Tainted Remedy. If an opponent would gain life, they lose that much life instead. We've seen a few of the cards in the past like that for black, so nothing new, not a new ability, but it's a nice one to still see in the set. And again, fits well with Liliana's story about trying to bring her brother back to life, but sort of failing and becoming a necromancer. We've all had weekends like that. Titan Strength, good for limited, and Timber Pack. So, first uncommon Undercity Troll. Then we have Acolyte of the Inferno, Enthralling Victor, and that is Armoret High Arbiter for the rare. So this is a Sphinx with flying, and when it enters the battlefield, your opponent reveals their hand, chooses the name of an online card revealed this way, and they can't cast spells with the chosen name. So it's, you know, locks them down a bit. Not terribly brilliant, unfortunately, just because of the high mana cost to cast it. And again, being on the body, the classic dice to removal argument. So, Sphinx's Tutelage. So this is a good blue enchantment. Whenever you draw a card, target opponent puts mills the top 2 cards in their library. If they're both non-land cards that share a colour, repeat the process. Horrible hoser for monocolour decks if you want to go down a milling route. And you, to get that extra draw sugar off, you can pay 6 mana to draw a card and discard a card, which then repeats the cycle. Necromantic Summons, Jessian Thief, Prowess, and deals combat damage to a player, draw a card, so a bit of card draw. And Demonic Pact. So this is showing Liliana's pact with the demons, which has given her a lot of power. This card's very interesting. So it's 4 mana. At the beginning of your upkeep, choose one that hasn't been chosen. So you can deal 4 damage to target creature playing game for life. Opponent can discard 2 cards. You could draw 2 cards. Or you lose the game. So very interesting, very, very useful card. Hopefully we'll see someone will come up with an interesting constructed deck revolving around Demonic Pact, but definitely a commander playable. So we'll jump through these again. Celestial Flare, nice to see that reprinted. Anointed of Champions, Demody Tome, Thunderclap Wyvern, flash flying and other creatures with flying at 1-1, so it's a nice flying lord. And we have Mizzium Meddler for a rare. So it's a wizard, 3 mana, with flash, and when ETBs, change target of the target spell ability to the Meddler. So I'm sure blue players will find lots of ways to abuse that. And we have Grasp of the Hieromancer foil. And another Thopter. So I'll dig through down to that juicy rare. Patron of the Valiant. Nice limited card. And Yavimaya Coast. Another plain land. Conclave Naturalists, Zendikar Incarnate, Ramroller, and what do I see here? That's Graveblade Marauder. So, Human Warrior with Death Touch, and when it deals combat damage to a player, that player loses life equal to the number of creature cards in your grave. So, this only gets, effectively, only gets stronger. You can see play in the some of the Warrior decks that are going around, but I'm much more of a modern player, I will confess, so great standards, not my environment, but with GP London on its way soon, I'm going to have to start learning. So, let's come through down to the uncommons, and the rare Giltleaf Winnower. So it's got Menace, so they finally keyworded the can't be blocked except by two or more creatures ability. It's a 4/3 for 5 mana, and when ETBs, destroy target non-elf creature with power and toughness that aren't equal. Bit of a interesting condition to have on there. So far it's not been a horrendous box. We've had some interesting stuff, but there's a lot more that we could hopefully get out of this. Send to Sleep. Saw that being played a lot at pre-release. Ravaging Blaze, Psychic Rebuttal, Throwing Knife, and that is Molten Vortex. 1 mana, red enchantment, discard a land card. It deals 2 damage to target creature or player. Yeah. And we got a Cruel Revival in foil. Such beautiful artwork on Macabre Waltz. Fire Impulse again. Water Corso. So we have Velaron Wardens, War Oracle, Dwinen's Elite, and that's a Shivan Reef. So we've got quite a few pain lands out of this box so far. So good for building up a multicolored deck for standard at the moment. Read the Bones, Kotok, still one of my favourites. Ringwarden Owl. So you have the Skyraker Giant, Murder Investigation, Possessed Scab, and Hallowed Moonlight. So white instant, 2 mana, until end of turn if a creature would enter the battlefield and it wasn't cast, exile it instead, and then draw a card. See some interesting combinations being used with that one. Wait, the Underworld Act of Treason. Oh, Act of Treason. Special Wills, Rogue's Passage. Goblin Pile Driver. Now, this set does have quite a strong tribal theme, as I said earlier. And this card is a much beloved reprint, and quite a surprise when we saw it as well in the spoiler season. So goblin with protection from blue, and when it attacks, it gets +2 to land a turn for each other attacking goblin. At the moment in standard, there's quite a few other goblins that can that are being played, so goblins have gotten a nice strong deck for standard. Oh yes. Greatly looking forward to this. Battle for Zendikar, October the 2nd. Cannot wait for that. Sometimes adverts are good. Right. Rogue Smallers, Debrid Shaman. So we have a Sky Snare Spider, Knightly Valor, Cruel Revival, and we're down to an Embermaw Hellion. So Trample. And if another red source you control deal damage to a permanent or player, it deals that damage +1 to instead. So it just increases the red damage output slightly. Not bad to get 4/5, but again, at 5 mana, it's a iffy one. So, go through these. We have Goblin Glory Chaser. Zendikar's Royal, Thopter Engineer. Oh, what do I see here? Kithian, Hero of Akros. So we've gotten the proxy card in there as well. So it's nice that you get that in the booster with him. So this is the young version of Gideon. He's just a 2/1 for one drop, but if him and at least two other creatures attacked, exile him, blink him back into control, blink him back into the battlefield, and he does also have pay 3 mana to gain indestructible, so even if you're forced to swing out to try and transform him, you can make him indestructible that turn. And here we have the Planeswalker, Gideon Battleforged. So he gains his name later on in life, it's granted to him by someone else. He looks like a very nice Planeswalker. Again, you can use him the turn he's flipped out, flipped over. So with 3 loyalty, you can immediately sort of +2 him to force a target creature, one of your opponent's creatures, to attack him during the next turn if they can. So make sure you have a blocker up, but it does put him up to 5 loyalty immediately, or until next turn target creature gains indestructible and untap it. Not as useful, but again, can be used for that extra blocking. And he has a 0 ability. Until end of turn, he becomes a 4/4 soldier with indestructible, who is still a planeswalker, and prevent all damage that would be dealt to him. So he turns into a nice swinging creature. Interesting, he doesn't have a big ultimate, doesn't create any emblems, but I think Kithian / Gideon is quite a favourite at the moment, so I'd expect to see him being played quite a bit. In a nice white weenie build, I imagine. So, on to the next pack though. Let's hope this keeps up and we get some more good ones. So there's a Tower Geist, a Chief of the Foundry, Citadel Castellan, and then we have a Displacement Wave. X, blue, blue, bounce, X. So, just a mass bounce. Oh, and an emblem for Chandra. So, yes, hoping for another Planeswalker. So, Shadow of the Past. Sentinel of Eternal Watch. This I saw absolutely sort of being played a lot, actually, I suppose is the way to put it, at a pre-release. It was most beloved and hated. Seismic Elemental, and then we have a Day's Undoing. So this is a blue mythic. It's a 2-mana sorcery. Right. Each player shuffles his or her hand and graveyard into the library, then draws 7 cards. If it's your turn, end the turn. So it exiles all spells and abilities on the stack, including this card. Discard down to your maximum hand size. Damage wears off, and this turn and until end of Turn Effects End. Now this is commanding quite a high price at the moment. When we first saw it, I think in spoiler season, the general opinion was, but someone out there, I'm sure, has figured out exactly a way to abuse it, and thus, it's going to be a sought-after card. So, go. Ring Warden again, Guardians. Fathering Wardens, Derridian Tome, Blightcaster, and we have Harbinger of Tide. So this card looks like it's going to be a give Blue Devotion a one last hurrah before it rotates out. It's a Merfolk, double blue. You can flash it if you pay an additional two, and when it ETBs, return target tapped creature and opponent controls to their hand. So it might bring a bit of life into Blue Devotion decks just before the rotation. We'll see. Green Devotion's such a big thing at the moment, so maybe Blue can come back. So we go through here. So there's some very nice artwork. I mean, some of them are reprints. In fact, a lot of these ones here are reprints. Because this is less of a core set and more of a proper expansion, there is a lot of new cards with a lot of new artwork as well. So another Sentinel Eternal Watch, and we've got a Mana Gorge Hydra, a normal one, things you got a foil earlier. But yeah, I like seeing more of the Planeswalker stories being told through the cards this time rather than just sort of online and in other places. So I'm really liking that we're actually seeing more story being told through the cards. And again, it's a nice set being able to see all these different planes that we've been to in the past, but it's just nice to see them all again, especially Zendikar. So Sphinx's Tutelage, Tormented Thoughts, Sylvan Messenger, and Animist's Awakening. So reveal the top X cards of your library, put all land cards from them on the battlefield tapped and the rest on the bottom of your library in a random order. But if you have two or more instants or sorceries in the grave, and tap those lands as well. So, nice bit of ramp, which green has been, I feel, has been lacking slightly lately, but yeah, it's a nice card, Animus Waking, and by the looks of it, here in this pack we have a Foil Sentinel, the Eternal Watch. Very nice. Ooh, and an Angel Token. Goes well with Sigil of the Empty Throne. So, Unholy Hunger starts us off on this pack. Blessed Spirits, Hydralash, Warhorn, and a Caves of Kalius. We're getting near to completing the entire set of Painlands. So, Night Snare. Track and Fodder, useful for those Goblin decks. Board Instincts, that's a nice Nissa stabbing a vampire there. So, Brawler's Plate. Quick Creatures, +2/+2, Trample. Cool. Skysnare Spiders, doing well Unlimited. Thopter Engineer as well. And Flame Shadow Conjuring. So whenever a non-token creature enters the battlefield under your control, pay a red. If you do, put a token on the battlefield that's a copy of it, it gains haste and exile. So nice little flash in the pan. Good for generating extra tokens for either a big finishing or, say, for example, abusing Thorcross's ability. So a few ways to abuse that card. So let's get through. We have Sphinx's Tutelage, War Oracle, Fleshbag Marauder, and Almaret's Archive. So, this is one of the mythic artifact. 5 mana to play. If you gain life, you gain twice that much life instead. And if you draw a card except the first one you draw in each, you draw steps, draw 2 cards instead. Oh, what we wouldn't give to have Sphinx's Revelation back. So, Ficus Disciple, Artificer's Epiphany, so, Eye Black Massacre, Acolyte of the Inferno, a Blood Cursed Knight, and another Museum Meddler. And a Goblin Token, because you always need more Goblin Tokens. Got a Revenant, Possessed Scab, Magmatic Insight, and another Embermore Hellion. Ooh! A Foil Case of Coilos. Coilos, sorry. Right, we're most of the way through this box. Nice to see a few more valuable cards, hopefully. So, Majoring Network, Somberworld Alpha, Despoiler of Souls, however, is our rare. Ooh, and then the Vix Barrier. So Despoiler of Souls, 2 mana black creature, it can't block, which is becoming a common theme for some of black. 2 in exile, 2 of the creatures from the from your grave, and return it from the grave to the battlefield, so it can reanimate itself. It's a 3-1, can't block. Ooh. Interesting black card. Interesting. So, Dark Dabbling, another Liliana card. Chandra's Fury, I'm pretty sure we know who that is. Chief of the Foundry, Whirler Rogue, Totem Guide, Languish. Now this card is making waves already. I reckon, in fact a lot of people do, and rightly so, think this is going to be played heavily in Standard. It's a black sorcery, 4 mana, all creatures get -4/-4 till end of turn. This is just a complete board wipe and a hoser. Yes, Magic has always had board wipes in set. I think it's just at the moment we are actually lacking a decent big bomb. Languish is going to take that place. It'll be interesting to see how it does. So, getting near the end of the box, Call of the Full Moon, Reclusive Artificer, Meteorite, and Nissa's Revelation. So, this is a green rare. Scry 5, then reveal the top card of your library. If it's a creature card, you draw cards equal to its power and gain life equal to its toughness. Interesting card, but it is up at 7 mana, so you really have to think about whether this is worth running. And it shows you sort of Nissa's Revelation when she meets the Eldrazi and realises, well, Zendikar might be in trouble. She might have made a mistake as well. So, Veteran's Sidearm, Malakir Coalblade, Enthralling Victor, Hydralash, Thopter's Spy Network. So Thopter's, there's a few cards in the set which generate and work around Thopter's, which is always fun. Everyone loves Thopter's. At the beginning of your upkeep, if you control an artifact, put a 1-1 Thopter onto the battlefield. Whenever one or more artifact creatures you control deals combat damage to a player, draw a card. So generate Thopters, draw more cards, make more Thopters. So, Anger to the Aether, Fiery Conclusion, Uragate Invocation, and we have Kithian's Irregulars. So this is the story of Kithian started out with his band of irregulars, just being the little kids that they are, effectively, but quite badass as well. Like goonies with swords. So, Renown 1 and Tap Target Creature. Two nice abilities. Elvish Visionary, always nice to see that in the set. Bounding Crisis, Totem Guide Heartbeast, Sigil of Valor, and another Animist's Awakening. And we have the Awoken World token as well. Prism Ring, so upgraded version of the other rings, effectively. Blessed Spirits, Citrus Starfish. Ooh, Nissa and a foil in this one, although it's a Subterranean Scout. So we have here Nissa, Miss Vastwood Seer. So she's 3 mana to drop, 2/2. When she enters the battlefield, you can get a forest out of your deck to hand. And when a land enters the battlefield, if you have 7 or more lands, you get to flip her. So she's actually relatively difficult to do in limited. Much easier constructed, though. And she flips to Nissa, Sage, Animist. So you can +1 to reveal the top card of the library. If it's a land card, put it on the battlefield, otherwise put it to hand. Then -2 to put a legendary 4/4 green Ashaya, the Awoken World, onto the battlefield. And then -7 to untap up to 6 target lands, and they become 6/6 elemental creatures that are still lands. So Nissa's original Planeswalker was very elf-centric, but now it's all about the lands. That wasn't bad for a penultimate pack. Let's see what our final pack brings us. So we'll enjoy this one a little bit more. Land of War Empath, good card. Grasp of the Hieromancer. So, Conclave Naturalist. Other Rogue's Passage. Patron of the Valiant. And we have, oh, it's blue, it's Displacement Wave. Shame. So, a little bit of a come down to the final pack, but oh well. So let's have a quick look. So let's double check just to see how many mythics we have pulled here. So overall, it's not been a terrible box. Put these lands to ones I'd say useful. We've had a nice few pulls out of this. I wouldn't be unhappy if I had paid for this myself. So, we almost completed a set of pain lands there. And mythics wise, didn't do too badly. Then we got 2 of the Planeswalkers, Kithian and Nissa. We got the Day's Undoing, which is always good to have, Demonic Pact, and the Halmaret's Archive. And there we have it. That is an unboxing for Magic Origins. It's a good set. I like the amount of flavour and story they've put into the cards. Really shows the characters, which is one of my favourite parts of Magic. And yeah, it seems like limited play for it is going to be very fun. The pre-release was greatly enjoyed by a lot of people. Draft will be interesting to see. I think there's a lot of strategies you can go for there. And it will just be time will tell how it will do with Standard. And there we go. So, thank you for watching. Remember, everything you've seen here today you can buy and trade on our website, bigorbitcards.co.uk. My name is Simon. Thanks for watching, and join me next time when I do some more unboxing videos for Magic Origins. Bye. Other Rogue's Passage. Patron of the Valiant. And we have, oh, it's blue, it's Displacement Wave. Shame. So, a little bit of a come down to the final pack, but oh well. So, let's have a quick look. So, let's double check just to see how many mythics we have pulled here. So, overall, it's not been a terrible box. Put these lands to ones I'd say useful. We've had a nice few pulls out of this. I wouldn't be unhappy if I had paid for this myself. So, we almost completed a set of pain lands there. And mythics wise, didn't do too badly. Then we got two of the Planeswalkers, Kithian and Nissa. We got the Days Undoing, which is always good to have. Demonic Pact and the Halmaret's Archive. And there we have it. That is an unboxing for Magic Origins. It's a good set. I like the amount of flavour and story they've put into the cards. Really shows the characters, which is one of my favourite parts of Magic. And yeah, it seems like limited play for it is going to be very fun. The pre-release was greatly enjoyed by a lot of people. Draft will be interesting to see. I think there's a lot of strategies you can go for there. And it will just be time will tell how it will do with Standard. And there we go. So, thank you for watching. Remember, everything you've seen here today you can buy and trade on our website, bigorbitcards.co.uk. My name is Simon. Thanks for watching, and join me next time when I do some more unboxing videos for Magic Origins. Bye.